Hey there, forgiveness community. How are you? I swear there was a way to share. There should be a way to share. But I don't see it. Let me see if this is it. No, I can't find it. How are you? This is Brenda Edelman. This is 30 Days of Forgiveness with Brenda. Welcome. I decided when all this coronavirus stuff started happening, I felt deeply guided to put the tools that I've learned over a lifetime into the hands of as many people as I can. And so I opened up my paid program, Phoenix Rising, a 30-day journey into and through forgiveness, into a free program for you to do right now. We are on day 15. Each week had a theme. The first week was self-forgiveness. The second week was forgiving our mother, and this week, starting today, is forgiving our father, and the next week will be forgiving God. There are daily lessons. You can still sign up today. I'll have to put a link in. There's let me see something. I have my computer open here. Sure would love to see if this was live and everything like that. I don't know why there's not a share button on here. Usually there is, but you know, there are so many people online right now. Let me see if I see this on the computer. There I am. Okay. Oh my gosh. It even looks like it is somehow doing... This is so odd. It's actually typing everything up of what I'm saying. So I better get clear. I did a live stream earlier and... Oh, it was through Zoom and it wasn't typing things up. Maybe this is something new. Hi, Karen. Maybe this is something new from Facebook, that if you do the live straight from Facebook, it actually gives you a transcription. How freaking cool is that? Okay, so this week is about forgiving our father. When you sign up today, and I'll post something somewhere. Hey, darling, I will. You will get all the lessons from this week, forgiving your father, and next week. And then the program will be opened up to purchase again, but I hope you will join us. There's lots of tools in there, and I'm coming live every day at 1 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, 4 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, every day right here on my Forgiveness and Freedom group, so that I can answer your questions. And because this is such an auspicious time, such an odd time, such a time of uncertainty, I want to take your questions on anything that you have learned or any questions you have about forgiveness and freedom. This is a favorite topic of mine from the themes of the week, which kind of seems crazy since forgiving my father was the biggest lesson of my life up until now. But the reason why I'm so excited about teaching this week is because being able to master this, being able to apply the loving to my father, finding compassion for him after he shot and killed my mother in 1995 and then married her sister, has been the thing that put me on track in my life and has helped me be on purpose as far as being able to teach others, help others. I have been speaking on forgiveness and coaching on forgiveness since 2005. And I have a very specific 3-step process that you guys can ask me questions on. I haven't gone over that specifically in this 30-day program, but I'm giving, in some ways I'm giving more because I'm giving a lesson a day. But there are certain things like identifying judgments, which is the lesson today was identifying judgments around your father. That is in my 3-step process, and it's also every week in self-forgiveness, forgiving your mother, forgiving your father, forgiving God. It's identifying what those judgments are. So step one of my process is moving out of denial and into acceptance of what is. And if you do not identify your judgments in a way, you could be in denial, because how many of us are, you know, compartmentalizing, putting things to the side and being like, that's okay. Either spiritually bypassing, saying, I have forgiven, when you actually haven't, because you've just compartmentalized, you haven't looked at it, you haven't let go of it. Or like I said, compartmentalizing is also a skill of survival. Like, oh, it's okay, I got it, which is not forgiveness, but it ends up hurting you, and it is the cause of dis-ease, whether that is physical dis-ease or emotional dis-ease or mental dis-ease being scattered, is when we put these emotional things away to the side and say, I got it, or it's just too painful to handle. And sometimes it's too painful in the moment, but if with the right help, getting a therapist, doing this kind of work, doing the writing, you'll feel freer. Thank you for the thumbs up. I mean, Karen is in my group, the Freedom Circle, which is open for you guys to join. I hope you'll join us. The sharing in there is amazing. And I just read inside the Freedom Circle shares from the members, and they're really deep and they're profound. And it's because they're doing this work. They're doing the work that you guys have access to these weeks right now, Phoenix Rising, the 30 Days of Forgiveness with Brenda, and the additional training in there. And I'm coaching people in a very private, sacred way. So that's in the Freedom Circle. If you want to find out more about that, definitely message me. It's a place for community. Hey, Cliff, good afternoon to you as well. Hopefully you are doing the exercises in this and finding some freedom, finding some freedom. So today we move into forgiving our Father. Today is about identifying the judgments you have against your Father. I'm not going to go over the lessons because the lessons specifically are pretty detailed, and they're in the lessons that go to your inboxes for those of you watching or those of you who are going to be watching later on the replay. But you are identifying where you have a judgment and how it even applies maybe to the masculine. How does it, if your father abandoned you, do you, like, this is about getting really aware. If your father abandoned you, do you project onto other men that they're not going to be there for you? Or like last week was about forgiving the feminine. If you project onto, if you have a mother who was not there for you or who is really controlling or untrustworthy, do you project onto other women that they're untrustworthy? This is about bringing the unconscious to conscious awareness so that you can have a better life now, so you can free yourself of these unconscious judgments that you've been holding on to. So focusing on the father. So I don't want to put anyone off because it's forgiveness. Forgiveness is for you. It's not like I forgive and I condone and just have someone hurt me all over again. That is never what my work is about. My work is always about, first and foremost, loving ourselves, forgiving ourselves, even when we're identifying the judgments we have against ourselves for things we have done or haven't done to others or to ourselves. It's about forgiving ourselves, loving ourselves, getting the lesson and moving on. I forgave my dad for shooting and killing my mother. I didn't do it like, okay, I'm going to do this now. I did it because my life sucked. I did it because I was miserable. I did it because I didn't know how to breathe. I didn't know how to have joy again while I was so angry at my father. And I didn't even know how much space he was taking up in my consciousness, because I talked about compartmentalizing at the beginning of this, because when we go through something traumatic, we often compartmentalize. You have to bring the unconscious to conscious awareness so that you can heal it. Heal it in the light of your loving. Heal it with prayer. Heal it with Ho'oponopono, which is a lesson later this week during week 3 of 30 Days of Forgiveness with Brenda. Make sure you sign up for those lessons. You get them to your inbox, and in them you get a lesson, an assignment, a prompt, a story, and an affirmation that helps you along, okay? So later in the week, we'll go over the Ho'oponopono. You want to bring the unconscious to conscious awareness instead of compartmentalizing and pushing down, because that's how we heal. We heal by bringing it out into the conscious awareness and in loving. One of the exercises last week, I think I introduced in this, was healing through stories. I know Karen and I, we talked about it, and you ended up doing a healing of memories on your own. Karen's a client of mine and a past client of mine who knows how to use these tools. But, inside the Freedom Circle, I also can offer insights and direction and what you should do with what you are dealing with specifically. This is not the time to have stuck energy inside you. This is the time. We have so much more time to be with ourselves. And instead of being frightened of being with ourselves, we can actually use this as a time to get to know ourselves and say, where else is healing possible? Where else do I, like, sometimes when we're so busy, we don't even know that we've been untrusting.
or we've kept people away, or we have less compassion than we think we do, or maybe we're not as kind as we think we are. Certainly, how many people can be like, I'm kind, and then they're not kind to themselves at all, right? A lot of people think about other people before they think of themselves. That's not loving. That's a way to be, to not have your energy. We cannot be depleted. The best thing we can do is to be healthy, look at our issues, heal the issues so that we can be focused, so that we can be the designer of our life, being just like a pinball in a machine that's knocking us around. And there's a lot of new information coming out right now. I mean, for me, it's a little bit better because I feel like now there's been some time. And so we're learning things even about this virus. I just watched a really interesting video about the Czech Republic does not have a lot of cases. It's because they're wearing the masks or the coverings. And of course, I know for me in America, hearing, oh, you don't have to wear masks. At least that's how I heard it in the beginning, because they didn't have enough supplies and just not knowing, you know, being in the unknown. Like, now that I'm hearing more things that are making sense and I'm understanding it more, I'm not as nervous as I was, but I'm also doing a lot of inner work, a lot of inner work. And so I'm encouraging you to do the inner work too. And part of that is getting the lessons in my program that I've just put on for free for you. It's my gift. There's another 2 weeks to get these. This week is on forgiving your father. Next week is on forgiving God. And a lot of the lessons this week are foundational lessons that are in my three-step forgiveness process that we've even used last week. Like I introduced the projections last week, you know, like where are you angry at your father? But it's because you have the quality within yourself that you are not acknowledging. I mean, that's one way of looking at a projection, or it's something that you like disown in yourself, or that you do yourself, but not in the same way. So this would work out, like an example of that might be anger, right? Let's say you don't consider yourself angry and you're really upset when people are confrontational, and then you have a father who's really confrontational and you're so angry at him. But if you look at it, you might think, huh, where are there times that I didn't speak up for myself and I wanted to be confrontational, but I was too scared? Like if you're triggered more than a than the moment should trigger you, it's because something is unresolved inside you and you have an opportunity to bring it up right now. So anyway, we introduced projections last week. We're working on it again this week. Last week was forgiving your mother. And so there's foundational techniques in there, even if you join now and you missed last week's, okay? So let me see if you have any questions. I'm just really connecting in these days for the connection, for the community. The lessons are delivered to your inbox. So if you have any questions, though, about, you know, forgiving your father, put them in here and I will give you an answer and give a link to join the program. Because even if you join late, the emails go out at 10 a.m. Pacific Standard Time every day. Even if it's later in the day, you'll get an email tomorrow that has a lesson from the day before. So the whole week will make sense to you. Okay. And everything builds upon the next thing. Let me just wait a second. See if there are any questions or if you want to share. It is possible to forgive. I did an interview earlier this week with a new friend and colleague. And she's like, it really actually seems like you forgave your father. Like, do you ever break down because you're just still in it? I'm like, nope. Doesn't mean I don't have other things that I'm not, that I don't get upset about. But my father, get this. I forgave my father for shooting and killing my mother and marrying her sister. When I think about my dad, I feel love for him. He does not have any bad effect on me. And I've done this with people who are alive that I've been upset with. That they have, there's no bad effect. I'm like, I'm okay. Like, how many of you have been divorced and you could think of like triggers on your exes? Wouldn't it be amazing if you could just let that go? Just be in the moment right now and just allow love in your life and compassion for that person and for yourself, because we all would do better if we could, right? For those of you who've been with narcissists, It's really important to forgive yourself so that you can have compassion also for the other person and just move on and create loving relationships now. Sometimes we don't want to forgive someone because what we really don't want to do is look at our responsibility in attracting that person. But how about you look at your responsibility? Because if you knew better, you would do better. Thank you for the hearts. And then you wouldn't attract that kind of person again. And you'd actually use it to love yourself instead of pushing it away and not taking responsibility. Last week, I introduced radical responsibility, and I'll have that again in this week's lesson. Cliff says, I had to realize my biological father was a drug addict. Yeah. And I think from our communication, that freed you a bit, right? Because then you didn't have to think about why he made the choices he did, because you're not dealing with someone that thinks like you. You're dealing with someone who's an addict. You're dealing with someone who doesn't think like you. Like, there's freedom in that. When I realized my father was a narcissist, oh my God, I didn't have to spend time trying to get him to see the light and to understand. Like, I, oh my God, it freed everything for me. And then Cliff says, I got divorced in 2016. Yes, to let that go. Exactly. I don't know where you are as far as letting that go, but wow, divorce is a hard one. But really what it is, I mean, for me, I'll speak for myself. A lot of my healing around my divorce was realizing that I chose, not only that I chose the person, because there was a lot of loving there, but that I stayed when I shouldn't have stayed. I looked at where I gave over my power. I looked at where I didn't stand up for myself. I looked at why I didn't leave. I looked at my patterns of codependence. I looked at my patterns of righteousness. I looked at why I feel like I'm entitled to anything. Like, all these things that we don't want to face are actually the key to our freedom. It's okay to expect a marriage to last forever. And it's okay that someone left or that you left. It's okay. You know why? Because it is. It is what it is. But if we don't take responsibility, we become a victim to the other person, and that disempowers us. It's like, it's okay to be a victim for a little while, and then you got to get over it. Otherwise, you're disempowered. And all of my work with all of my clients and with myself is about being empowered so we can make better choices. Cliff says, yes, because I would always curse when I thought of him. Oh yeah, your father, right? Oh, I know. I had times where my dad was in my life and out of my life after what happened with my mom. And I would think that if he's out of my life and I'm not answering his calls, that I'd be fine. But I wasn't fine, because it would even be that I think of him and my whole day would be wrecked. It would literally be me creating toxic energy in my body and my mind because of a thought of him. He did nothing. That's where we're responsible. Now, granted, our brains are a certain way, and those thoughts are in there. You know, Joe Dispenza work, all the scientific work and stuff like that. But we are the only ones who can let ourselves free. That's why we are the only ones that can let ourselves free from having the same thoughts over and over again and change those neural pathways. It's really important. It's not them. They can't. It's only us. Yes, because I would always, Cliff says, you can't wish bad stuff on an ex, especially when you have children with them. You can, but you're right. It's not great, especially if you have kids with them, because those kids are made from the two of you. It's like, I'm just getting this. Don't take offense to anybody, but it's almost like you're wishing something bad on your child when you're wishing something bad on them. I don't know how that connection, I'm going to have to look at that. But I remember having this huge breakthrough as the daughter, hating my father, and realizing that when I hated my father, I was hating a part of myself. And so in some weird way, these parents who are like hating on their kids, granted, they're, you know, hopefully they're hiding that from the kids. But if they're hating on their kids, and some do hate on them in front of the kids, in a way, you are like hating on your child and almost like it's almost like putting upon your child that they should hate themselves because they're made of them. So if a parent hates them and they see that, That's so confusing for the child. Then they'll be in therapy saying, why do I hate myself? Even though it's really tricky because there are people who are narcissists, people who are just awful. So how do you protect your child that you would like to protect? How do you educate them and let them know, mom or dad, your dad or your mom are doing these things that make no sense, that aren't nice, that aren't kind, but that has nothing to do with you. You're so precious. You know what I'm saying? Like that extra effort. The interesting stuff. Yeah. Okay. Are there any other questions? Got any questions about the lessons? It's awesome. We're having a great discussion in the Freedom Circle about Phoenix Rising, 30 Days of Forgiveness with Brenda. But you can certainly post your questions here as well if you're not part of that group. I do invite anyone who's listening to this to join the Freedom Circle. It's another couple months of using this material and other material to really go deep, to really, really communicate in a contained space that is intimate and it's not open to the public. And tomorrow I'll be back. Today was about identifying your judgments. Tomorrow might be about projections. I think it probably is. Seeing all those judgments, oh, where do you have those judgments about yourself maybe? If I judged my father as cold-hearted, oh, this was a big one for me. I had a freaking huge insight, but it was literally, oh my God, 6 years after my mom died. That's how long I was holding this shit. That's why I teach this. I realized, oh my God, my heart's so cold because any time I think about my father, I shut my heart down. But that heart that I was protecting from him, I was shutting it down to myself and not letting people who were so loving in. Because that part in our heart closes down to everyone. So there's a projection for you. So you might want to look at that. So go through the lessons and do the homework and then come back tomorrow and share with me any insights that you have. Okay, I don't see anything. I don't see any questions or any other comments. Blessings to you, and I will talk to you tomorrow.